basically what happened, we were going through this chapter. Screen is visible to you? Screen is visible? Okay. So we have come to know that those two persons, Guru and his disciple, they both were so hungry. So they thought that they should purchase some of the grocery. And it was so surprising thing that everything was available at our same price. Okay. So whether they were purchasing rice or whether they were purchasing bananas, all were available on the same price. Dudu is a unit of a price. At that time, the name of the currency was Dudu. I have written a unit of price, what you can say. Currency. Okay, bachche. So after that, the Guru and his follower, they both were so happy because they have never got a chance to do such kind of things that all the things were available on same price. So they purchased so much food for single rupee. They cooked that food, they relished that food, they enjoyed it. And after that, what happened? After that, what happened? Guru, he did not want to stay there. He wanted to leave that place. What was the reason behind that? He thought that if such kind of funny rules are, such kind of foolish rules are going there, so this kingdom cannot last forever. And in next day or tomorrow in future, there can be some tweet, there can be some strange rules. So they planned that they should leave that place. So Guru said, okay, just let's go from this place. But his follower, okay, he did not want to leave that place. He wanted to stay there, he wanted to enjoy the food there because he thought that the food available, it was of very cheap price, okay? So Guru said that all the persons are fools here and they will not last forever. And that's why you can't tell what they will do next. It means what activity they are going to do, what rule they are going to make afterwards. You cannot say anything. But disciple, he did not want to listen to Gurus, okay? And he, after that, Guru had to listen to his follower and he said, okay, you just do whatever you want to do here, but I am going to leave that place. And he left that place. He moved from there, but his follower stayed at that place. So follower was staying at that place. He was purchasing so many food items because he was really fond of eating. And when he purchased so many things like bananas, ghee, rice, wheat, so he ate to his fill. Okay? It means whatever he was able to eat, he ate more than that because of that greed. Okay? And what was the result of that? He became so fat. Okay? And he became so fat like a street side sacred bull. So his physical infrastructure, his physique is described like a sacred bull. Okay, even you can say he became so fat like a street side sacred bull. Yes, he became so, he gained so much weight. He became so fat that he got that obesity. Okay. So what was the result? That because that person was short-sighted. Here I have told you, na, that person was so greedy, so short-sighted that he wanted to enjoy only about present. He did not think about this thing that if he would be eating too much, more than his capacity, what would be the result? See, if it happens with us, if we go to any restaurant and if we think that this food is available at a very cheap price, so we start eating and consuming more and more, what will be the result? Our stomach would get upset, we can fall ill, we can fall sick, we can even vomit also. So he was not thinking about it, he was not far-sighted, he was only short-sighted, very much greedy person. Up to that chapter is clear? Shall I move further? Okay. So after that, there is a very funny incident. What is that incident? That in the house of a merchant, one of the thief came. So when thief started entering in that house, he will start laughing afterwards. So when he wanted to cross that wall, that thief, the wall was so weak that it fell down, okay, and thief killed. He died at the moment. And when thief's brother came to know about the demise, about the death of his brother, he went straight to the king and he lodged a complaint. Against whom? Yes, he lodged a complaint against merchant that this merchant should be severely punished. Why so? What was the reason? Because his house wall was so weak that his brother got died in that, you can say, wall, because of the pressure of that wall. So when that, you can say, complaint was lodged against a merchant in front of the king, what decision was taken? So now there is a surprise, there is a suspense. Let's read about this. No, king was fool. You'll be surprised to know about the decision, what decision was taken. And see, there was one not culprit. Merchant was not culprit. Now there would be a chain of so many culprits. It means, culprit means person who has done a crime. So now only merchant was not only to blame. He blamed someone else. Someone else blamed some another else. And some another else blamed some. So there was a chain of culprit. At last, who was a real culprit? Who was a real victim? This is a surprise. Let's go through. Ramanjeet, show me your face. Keep your camera on. There can be some fake ID. Ramanjeet, still taking her breakfast? Tell me, your recess is over. Ramanjeet, show me your face. Okay, Dhiren, you show me your face. Start reading.
Okay. The king said, "Justice will be done. Don't worry." And at once summoned the owner of the house.
Wait. Read from there. One bright day, a thief broke into a.
Okay, ma'am. One bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in. And as he was carrying out his loot, the wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. His brother ran to the king and complained, "Your Highness, when my brother was pursuing his ancient trade, a wall fell on him and killed him. This merchant is to blame. He should have built a good strong wall. You must punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family for the injustice." The king said, "Justice will be done. Don't worry." And at once summoned the owner of the house.
Okay. Now in this page, what we have come to know difficult words also. It's better that you write down the meanings. See, so one bright day, one of the incident is described here, that once upon a time there was a thief. On bright day, he went into a rich merchant's house, okay, and in order to enter into that house, he made a hole, okay, and through that hole, he wanted to enter into the house. So, and sneaked in means What is the meaning of sneak? Sneak means entered secretly. Write down the meaning of sneak. Sneaked means entered secretly. Okay, use whiteboard so that others can also see. Yes, because for bright day, what was for them? Night. So it means if thief wants to go for stealing, so which time they were choosing? For day. Okay. So when they sneak, when he sneaked, sneak means entered secretly. Okay. So he entered there, sneaked through there and loot. What is the meaning of loot? Yes, it means stolen material. It means stolen material. Okay, collapsed. What is the meaning of collapsed? Collapsed means fell down. Write down the meaning of collapsed. It means fell down. Wrongdoer. A person who is responsible. Who is responsible for wrong actions. So, bachche, write down the meanings of these difficult words. Only then you'll be able to understand the text what is given here. Collapsed, it means fell down, and wrongdoer means a person who is responsible for wrong actions. Written? So basically what was going on? So when bright day, when thief wanted to enter into the rich merchant house, so he made a hole, and through that hole in the wall, he wanted to secretly enter into that house. So as he was carrying a loot, loot here means as he was carrying a lot of stolen material, the wall of the old house, it was a basically old house, the wall became so weak, so it fell down. Okay, so when it fell down on the head of a thief, so on the spot thief died. So when his brother came to know about this thing, his brother went to king to complain. Okay, so when the complaint was lodged, okay, so what was the result of that? Because he was pursuing means he was getting, because ancient trend, very old trend was going on, so that's why the blame was made that that merchant should have made a very strong and very good wall. Okay, so what plea was made, what request was made in front of a king? The request was that the strong wall should be made. Okay, but now who is culprit, who is victim? Merchant, because he did not bother about making a strong wall of the house, so that's why that merchant should be severely punished and he should compensate the family for this injustice. It means whatever the injustice is done with the thief family, that compensation means suppose any of the accident occurs with that family member, so compensation is given. It means the money in the form of a help, yes, to fulfill their basic needs. So that compensation should be given by merchant to the culprits, to the family of a victim. Okay, so the king said, the king promised, yes, the justice will definitely be done. The, you can say, law will be in your favor, because merchant was wrong, whatever he has done, it was wrong. So he is summoned. What is the meaning of summoned? Yes. So write down the meaning of summoned. Summoned means called. So he called the owner of the house. Who was the owner of the house?
Merchant.
That merchant. Okay. Now who will read from there when the merchant arrived? Who is going to read from there? Okay, Lakshya, you read. Lakshya, you read from there when the merchant arrived.
Yes, ma'am.
Start reading.
When the merchant arrived, the king questioned him, "What's your name?" "Such and such, your highness." Where you at home? When the dead man burled your house?" "Yes, my lord. He broken in the wall and was weak. It fell on him. The accused pleads guilty. Your wall killed this man's brother. You have murdered a man. We have to punish you, Lord," say the helpless merchant. I didn't put up the wall. It's really the fault of the man who built the wall. He didn't build it right. You should punish him. Who is that, my lord? This wall was built in my father's time. I know the man. He's an old man now. He lives nearby. The king sent out messenger to bring in a bricklayer who had built the wall. They brought him and tied hand and foot. You pulled this man's wall in his father's time? Yes, my lord, I did. What kind of wall is this that you built? It has fallen on a poor man and killed him. You have murdered him. We have to punish you by that. Before the king could order the execution, the poor bricklayer failed. Please listen to me before you give your orders. It's true, I built this wall and it was not good, but that was because the mind was not on it. I remember very well a dancing girl who was going up and down that street all day with her anklets jingling, and I couldn't keep my eyes or my mind on the wall I was building. You must get that dancing girl. I know where she lives. You are right. The case depends. We must look into it. It is not easy to judge such a complicated case. Let's get that dancer everywhere she is. The dancing girl, who an old man, came trembling to the court.
Wait, wait. Now I'm going to explain. Now there is a lot of fun. You people are going to enjoy and laugh. So now, what happened basically? What happened? Just see. What happened basically? Now when merchant was summoned, summoned means called. So when merchant was summoned, called in front of kingdom, so the king questioned him, what is your name? Okay, such and such, your highness. It means he was so completely afraid when he was called in front of a king. Okay, so he asked him that when that thief came into your house, were you present in that house? He said, yes, he was present in his house. And that person came, the wall was so break, it fell on him and it really killed a man. So such kind of episode, such kind of incident was described to the owner of the house, to the merchant. The merchant was, you can say, said that you should be now punished because you are to be blamed. Okay. So now merchant was feeling so helpless. So he spoke in front of a king. See, listen, king, this wall is not made by me. This wall is so much old and it is made by my father. Okay. And in the time of father, it was made. But who made this wall? Yes, it was made by, you can say, word is not coming in my mind. Mason, jo masons hote hain. A bricklayer, bricklayer, yes. Mason, bricklayer, that this wall is not made by me. It was made in the time of my father. And this weak wall was made by bricklayer, Mason. Okay, so that person should be, you can say, punished. So, after that, king asked him, do you know that bricklayer person who has made that wall? So, with 101% surety, he said, yes, I know that person. Okay, now that person should be called. So, the bricklayer was called. He came. Now when punishment was for bricklayer, so bricklayer pleaded. Pleaded means he made a request. So pleaded means requested. So now bricklayer, he put a blame on someone else. Now you will laugh. On whom? So bricklayer, he said, now I'm not a culprit. I'm not to be blamed. Why so? Because what is the reason behind that? What is the reason behind that? Because the poor bricklayer, he made a request. Please listen to me, because before you put any order, before you pass your result, that who's to be blamed, just listen to me. Okay, I agree that I have made that wall. This wall is made by me. But this wall was not made in a good way. Why so? Because when I was making a wall, I got distracted. I was not able to do that work. So king asked, who distracted you? He said, there was one dancing girl who distracted my attention. Okay, because of that dancing girl, I was looking at that girl. I was not able to concentrate on my work. And this dancing girl was passing through the, you can say, street. She was having anklets. Anklets, you can say, this is an ornament that is worn around our feet. Okay. So that dancing girl, she was going and coming up and down. She was going in street all day. And her anklets were jingling. Jingling means they were making sound. It happens now. Sometimes women wear anklets, yes, and it makes tinkling sound. Okay, so anklets is a ornament worn over feet, worn over feet. And jingling means creating sound. So these anklets were making sound. So because of the distraction of that sound, I got distracted and I was not able to concentrate on my work. I was not able to concentrate on my work, and my mind was not on my work. My mind was towards that dancing girl. After that, king, he asked him, "Do you know where is that dancing girl?" He said, "Yes, I know her. Where is she?" So she should be blamed. She should be punished. Isn't it strange? Okay. Now the case becomes so, you can say, deepened, so complicated. Now, before king could announce execution, execution means punishment, that who should be punished. So the poor bricklayer, when he requested and he blamed that dancing girl, okay. So the case was becoming deep and deep. And now he said that now it is not so easy to judge such a complicated case. Let us go to that dancer, find out where is she. Okay. Now, because that dancer at the time of his father, now the dancer would become an old woman. Now that dancer has become an old woman, and she was called in the court, and she was just trembling, having a stick in her hand, and she was so afraid of king that now she is going to be punished. Okay. So what question was asked to that lady? Did you walk up and down that street many years ago while this poor man was building a wall? Did you see him? So such kind of question was asked from that dancing girl, that you were taking round in that street when that poor man was making wall. So she accepted this thing. She said, "Yes, I was taking round. I was moving in that." Okay. So she said, "Yes, I remember it very well." Okay. So your anklets were jingling. They were creating sounds. You were so young at that time, and you tried to distract that poor man who was making, who was busy in making a ball, and she, distracted him, and because of that reason, he made a bad ball, and now this ball has fallen down, and this ball has fallen on a poor burglar. Burglar is a thief, okay, and this, because of this reason, this innocent man has been killed, so you deserve to be punished. You poor lady, you dancing girl, you should be punished. Now that lady, she thought for a minute, and now another chain became, she put that blame on someone else. Who is that? You should be very much inquisitive to know. No, wait. Now she thought for that for a minute, and she said, "Now I just tell you why it was happening, why it was a jingling sound my anklets were making, and why I was going through that lane again and again, why I had to take so many rounds there. What was the reason? I just tell you." So Simran, you read further.
Yes, ma'am.
Listen. Yes, read.
She thought for a minute and said, "My lord, wait. I know now why I was walking up and down that street. I had a goldsmith to make some jewelry for me. He was a lazy scoundrel. He made so many excuses, said he would give it now and he would give it then, and so on all day. He made me walk up and down to a dozen times. That was when this bricklayer saw me. It's not my fault, my lord. It's the damned goldsmith's fault."
Yes, read further.
"Poor thing. She is absolutely right," thought the king. "Bring the evidence. We have got the thieves at once." The king's bailiff searched for the goldsmith, who was hiding in a corner of his shop. When he heard the accusation against him, he had his own story to tell.
Okay. Afterwards. Okay, now.
My lord, that, he said.
Okay, read. Okay, Achana, time is running out. I just want to explain up to this. Wait. So what happened? So what excuse was made by that lady? She said, okay, I accept this thing that I was taking around. Okay, but what was the reason? What was the reason of that? You know, because the reason was that because I had given some gold to the goldsmith, I wanted to give order to that goldsmith for the jewelry. Okay. And that goldsmith was a lazy scoundrel. She, you can say, spoke that word for that goldsmith, that person was a mean person. Okay. He was taking so much time. He was making so many excuses. And he was saying, now I will give you jewelry. Afterwards, I will give you jewelry. So this was the reason that I have to take so many rounds to that goldsmith. Okay. Dozen of time. It means so many times I have taken round of his shop. Okay. To take my order. Okay. So this was the reason that I have to pass through the street because I was going to that goldsmith again and again to get my order. Okay. Now King said, okay, now finally the real culprit has been found. Who is the real culprit?
The
goldsmith. Goldsmith. So goldsmith is there. So that person should be punished. That person should be punished. So the person from the kingdoms, bailiffs, those who were appointed on duty, those persons were sent. Okay, so they started finding about goldsmith. Where is that person? And that person was finally found. Okay. And when that person was brought into the kingdom, so he was having his own story to tell. Now, finally, when execution was to be told in front of that goldsmith, now you are to be punished. So goldsmith, he told a different story. Now there was a chain network of culprit. So this thing we will come to know tomorrow. So be now you all should be very much curious to know that what story was cooked by a goldsmith. What do you think? Make a guess. Speak in English and softly. See. Goldsmith said that he was a very poor goldsmith, okay, and he said, okay, I accept this thing that dancer, that girl was coming to my shop so many times, okay, I was making so many excuses because I couldn't finish her order, I couldn't make her jewelry on time, why so? Because of the order of rice merchant. Because I was having already a big order of rice merchant and that dancer was coming again and again to get her order fulfilled. But I was not able to make her order. Why so? Because I was overburdened with the work of rice merchant. And who was that merchant? In whose house burglar came. So now finally decision was made. Who was the culprit? Merchant in whose house burglar came. And this merchant was now alive. He was. Okay. We will continue this tomorrow. Have a nice day. Be inquisitive to know what happens.